As expected, the Philippine Central Bank keeps key interest rates at record lows. The overnight reverse repurchase rate remains at 2%. The interest rates on the overnight deposit and lending facilities were also kept at 1.5% and 2.5% respectively. This was the sixth straight policy meeting that the central bank held off on adjusting rates as it tries to support economic recovery amid continuing disruptions caused by the pandemic. As for inflation, the central bank expects consumer prices to settle slightly above the upper end of government's target range of 2 to 4% in 2021.
Fish Solutions again slashes its 2021 growth forecast for the Philippines as the country struggles to contain new COVID-19 outbreaks. It now sees the local economy growing by 4.2% for the year, down from its earlier projection of 5.3%. It cites the latest lockdown in Metro Manila and the heightened threat posed by the Delta variant as reasons for the downgrade. The think tank adds the Philippines still has a long way to go from achieving herd immunity, which delays a further reopening of the economy. The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines warns power prices may continue to increase in the coming months. It says the rate hikes will be due to the proposed frame of ancillary services contracting of the Energy Department. Under the policy, NGCP will be compelled to procure all its ancillary services requirements under a contract where providers will be paid for a 24/7 availability regardless of actual utilization.
May malaking posibilidad na pag fully implemented na yan, may makikita tayong pagtaas ng presyo ng kuryente, specifically dito sa ancillary services. Kaya naman namin pinaglaban yan eh. Kasi alam ko na pag pumasok yung ancillary services increase, nasa ilalim ng transmission yan, iisipin ng tao, NGCP. Hindi. Wala sa amin yan eh. That's generation.
Power rates have been going up for 5 straight months. Senator Risa Hontivero says the latest hike should be suspended until industry players explain the reason behind the increase.
And these agencies left us the assurance that there will be no increase in transmission charges, even if non-firm contracts of the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines' ancillary services were converted to firm contracts. Lip service lang ba ito? I am expecting ERC to diligently exercise its regulatory functions to the fullest and ensure that consumer welfare is protected and power rates and service are justly regulated without further delays, especially in bringing down the price of our electricity. If not, then they should voluntarily resign from their posts.
Talks of a possible longer lockdown in Metro Manila put many workers and businesses on edge. More from Warren De Guzman.
COVID-19 cases are surging. The Department of Health says things could get better, but that depends on the length of the current enhanced community quarantine in affected areas, including the National Capital Region. The Health Department's projections show a 5-week ECQ would result in the least number of active cases by the end of September in NCR. The thought of a total of 5 weeks of hard lockdown has many employees and small business owners panicking.
Sa positive side, yun, ang iniisip lang ko ng gobyerno natin, eh, maprotektahan tayo bawat isang mamamayan ng Pilipino. Pero sa negative side, syempre, iisipin din natin yung paano mabubuhay ang mga Pilipino.
The Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry says a 5-week lockdown could destroy any economic momentum gained in the second quarter. The Makati Business Club says it will support the government's decision, but if more jobs and businesses can be saved, the recovery will be that much faster. The Health Department admits the economic cost of a longer ECQ might be too much to bear. The National Economic and Development Authority says the current community quarantine levels in place in NCR and other affected areas around the Philippines are already costing the economy over 150 billion pesos per week. That's 600 billion pesos total for the next week and the 3 weeks after that if government pulls the trigger on a 5-week ECQ. The Philippine Central Bank says fiscal aid and accelerated vaccination will be crucial.
Be in position. Quarantine measures, arrest the recent wave of COVID-19 infections, could pose a risk to the ongoing economic recovery. To this end, targeted fiscal and health interventions, especially the acceleration of the government's vaccination program, will be crucial, safeguarding public health and preventing deeper negative effects on the Philippine economy.
Vice President Lenny Robredo says if any extension is needed, it should be targeted based on data.
Parati namang sinasabi natin na lahat na desisyon dapat nakabase sa datos. Kailangan ba talaga? Kasi yung isa namang tinitingnan at ito yung pinopropose ng ibang mga experts na hindi naman kailangan na buong Metro Manila.
Warren De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.